Everyone knows that quickscopers get all the pussy. Snipers get some as well, but let's be honest, most of that is just runoff from the quickscopers. Man, I still remember that day like it was yesterday, 13 years old, hitting that 360 trick shot off the middle building in high rise. My goodness, I must have given at least half of Mrs. Thompson's grade 6 class the clap. Maybe you can relate. Maybe that's why you clicked on this video in the first place. Well, let me tell you, you came to the right place. Because we're about to figure out which is the best quickscoping weapon in Modern Warfare. Is it the AX50? Is it the Kar98K? Which I know is technically labeled under the marksman rifle, but it's used for quickscoping. It's not to be used like the MK2. No, comparing those two weapons would be like comparing apples to ass cheeks. It would be ludicrous. It's to be compared against the AX50, so let's determine which gun is best for quickscoping. Now, if you're completely unfamiliar with one of these guns or both of these guns, the main thing that the Kar98K is supposed to offer over the AX50 is its mobility. It's supposed to be fast, quick, aim down sight speed is supposed to be much quicker than the AX50. It's the Jose Altuve of the Modern Warfare world, where the AX50, on the other hand, is more like the Bartolo Colon of the Modern Warfare world. If the Kar98K doesn't have mobility on the AX, then the Kar98 is useless. So let's go ahead, and before we get started, let's set up our Kar98K with all three attachments that increase its aim down sight speed. And since the AX50 is the challenger here, it's got some tricks up its sleeve. Yes, it does. Let's equip it with all five of the attachments that increase its aim down sight speed and mobility. And the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make a big assumption, but I don't think it's that big. We're going to put a scope on the Kar98K because the iron sights are trash. Take it from someone who has gold for this weapon. The iron sights are not going to do you any favors. So we're going to go ahead and clean that up, and we're going to throw on the Cronin 3.5 sight. This sight, along with many of the other reflex and red dot sights, are the quickest sights that we can throw on. And likewise, we'll do the same thing with the AX50. So now we got the preliminaries out of the way, let's get to testing. So to get this whole thing started, the whole reason we did that song and dance was for the mobility, the aim down sight speed. So let's see exactly where we stand in terms of speeds between these two guns. There's the Kar98K. Did you blink? You might have missed it. It's pretty quick, not gonna lie. And here's the AX50. Also pretty quick, so obviously we're gonna need to take an in-depth look here. Something really interesting happens here when you take a look in slow motion. So I want you to look on the left, which is the Kar98K. I've paused the video where I think it has completed its ADS. But you'll notice the scope isn't fully zoomed in, it's not fully aligned to the center of the screen. And if I play a few more frames, let's just ignore the AX right now. If I play a few more frames, you can see the scope align itself and completely finish its ADS animation. So you might be wanting to say that this frame right here is when the ADS animation is complete. This is when the timer should stop. But if we look at where we originally stopped this frame, you can see our reticle is actually pretty close to the target. Now, if we were farther away at long range, this inaccuracy would be further enhanced and therefore might not be on target. But this is a pretty ideal quickscope range, therefore I'm gonna say that this is when the ADS animation for the Kar98K is complete. Now, if I bring back the AX50, I think we have to skip forward a few more frames to say that this animation is complete, that this animation will be on target. So if I skip ahead a frame, it still doesn't look like we're quite on target, but one more frame kinda looks very similar to the Kar98K. So why am I doing this? Why aren't I just waiting for the scopes to fully be centered? Well, watch what happens when I skip forward one frame. The Kar98K just snaps to center like that. It is fully there, ready to go. The AX50, on the other hand, takes its sweet time to really get aligned perfectly to the center. This is why the AX50 feels a bit more sluggish than it actually is compared to the Kar98K. At least within close to medium range, this extra time it takes to get perfectly centered is really not noticeable at close to medium range. At long range, this would cause some inconsistencies with your quickscoping, but when we're talking about that ideal quickscoping range, the AX50 actually gets its sight on target a bit faster than it appears, albeit still slower than the Kar98K. So unfortunately, the ADS time is a bit of a judgment call, and I've pleaded my case to you guys. And if you're on my train of thought, let's go back to the initial frames where I said these ADS animations were pretty much complete. So at this point, the Kar98K took 15 frames to get into this position, which is about 250 milliseconds. And the AX50, on the other hand, took 2 more frames than that. Sitting at 17 frames, that's 283 milliseconds. So that's a difference of about 34 milliseconds. Now, if you need a point of reference for that, most of the hybrid sights, the dual sights that you can put on guns, have a 34 millisecond increase in the ADS time. So the difference between the Kar98K and the AX50 is basically the difference between a gun with no sight on it whatsoever and throwing on one of the hybrid sights. Now I just want to quickly cover the sprinting to ADS time. Here you can see both guns in full speed. See, it's not that noticeable of a difference, at least to me. If we slow things down here, we're going to see the exact same thing. On the left, the Kar98K is right on target, so we're going to call it there. And then just like the AX50 in the normal ADS, if I skip ahead not one frame, but two frames there, you can see that the AX50 is pretty much on target like the Kar98K is. So respectively, both of these guns when sprinting take one more frame than when not sprinting. So you have 266 milliseconds and 300 milliseconds for the AX50. So long story short, basically what I've seen from this video is yes, the Kar98K is significantly faster than the AX50, but the AX50 may seem slower than it actually is. It just takes a little bit longer to get completely lined up. So the Kar98K is yes, a little bit faster as we expected, but the AX50 is not that far behind and the animation makes it seem slower than it is. However, it may be just a tad bit more inaccurate. But what are we giving up for the Kar98K to be quicker and for the AX50 to be not as accurate? Well, let's take a look at the damage. Now keep in mind, Big Zane over here, he's got 300 health, so he's not dropping anytime soon. Standard health is 100. First things first, using the Kar98, let's see the headshot damage. 172 damage, so that'll be a one-shot kill to the head as expected. So let's see about the upper chest. 154 damage, that's another one-shot kill. But let's see how low we can go. Right above his beef whistle, we're going to be doing 86 points of damage, which is not going to be enough to one-shot kill. That means the Kar98K can only one-shot kill from the upper chest and the head. Now I've got the big AX50 on my hands, let's do the same tests. Aiming right for the aviators, we're going to be doing 214 to the head. Yep, that'll do one shot. How about the upper chest? 112 damage, that's a one-shot, one kill. Now what about this time for the waist and up? Just barely 102 damage, we're going to be doing a one-shot kill from the waist up, unlike the Kar98K. Therefore, using the AX50 significantly increases the surface area you have to one-shot kill your opponents. But we have to factor in the range when it comes to these hitboxes and its one-shot kill abilities. So let's take a look at that. I want to stay on the topic of the AX50 and its ability to one-shot from the waist up. Well, how far exactly can this AX50 do that? Here you can see I'm trying to find out just exactly how close I have to be in order to get a one-shot from the waist up. Slowly but surely, I just take a meter step each time and see if I can get that one-shot kill. And right here is the range I finally get the one-shot kill from the waist up. So this is as far as I can be away from my target in order to get that one-shot kill from the waist above. And the game says this is a 66 meter range. If I go any further than this, I'll need to shoot from the upper chest and head. And now we're going to move on to the Kar98K and look at its upper chest to the head range. I've moved up quite a few meters from the AX50, and you'll notice with the Kar98K, even at this closer range, I still can't one-shot kill to the upper chest with the Kar98K. I'm going to take one step forward, and there we found just how far away I can be to one-shot kill to the upper chest. So the game says this is 55 meters, and as long as I shoot to the upper chest or the head, this will be a one-shot kill. Now I actually marked these locations. So this first X is where we were with the AX50. And as long as I'm within here or closer to my target, I will be able to completely one-shot kill from the waist above. Now, this is quite a distance away to be quickscoping, and maybe this distance is not needed. But nevertheless, from this distance to my target, I have quite a big target to shoot and get that one-shot kill. All the way from the waist above is gonna get me that kill. Now if I move up to the second X, this is how far away I can be with the Kar98K in order to get that one-shot kill from the upper chest to the head. This is quite a distance as well. You're not going to be sniping with the Kar98K, you're going to be quickscoping, so you're probably going to want to be closer to this anyways. But nevertheless, the AX50 has way more range than the Kar98K, and it doesn't need to be nearly as accurate as the AX50 has the ability to one-shot from the waist above. One of the last very important things I want to talk about is the flinch between these two guns. Flinch is how much your gun moves when you're being shot at, Basically, the more flint you have, the harder it's going to be to stay on target when you're being shot at. Now on the left, as always, we have the Kar98K, on the right we have the AX50, and this is what happens when you're shot at by an assault rifle. Now it's actually quite a big difference if we slow things down. We're going to go ahead and stop the videos when the flinches are at their most extremes. On the left, the Kar98K has a bit of flinch, however, depending on how close you are, the flinch might actually help you aim a little higher on your target to get that one-shot kill, kind of like old school Call of Duty. On the right, you have the AX50. Oh my god, someone get this guy a map. He is lost. We're completely out to lunch, not even anywhere near the target. If you get shot first, you're going to completely miss your shot, probably. Now, one thing we haven't talked about is with the Kar98K, we have only used 4 of its available attachment slots. So a good idea is to put a perk on, and one of the perks is to handle the flinch a little bit better. The AX50 has all 5 attachments, we can't put anything else on it. So if you decide the focus perk is where you want to put your 5th attachment for the Kar98K, this is what it's going to look like. The Kar98K with focus on the left barely even moves, and once again the AX50 is doing god knows what again. Now there's nothing stopping you from putting focus on the AX50, but you're going to take away one of those aim down sight speed attachments, and then you're going to further increase the gap between the mobility of the two guns. It's just not worth going down. Remember, we want to be as mobile as possible to compare ourselves to the Kar98K. And the last thing I want to talk about is the fire rate. Fire rate is really important if you're quickscoping. You know, you're up close to the enemy, you need to take out probably multiple enemies as quick as possible. So a slow fire rate really hinders your ability to do that. On the left, the Kar98, the right, the AX50. So the Kar98K shoots a little bit faster, but not that much faster than the AX50, and I think that's one big downfall of the Kar98K, is its inability to shoot fast even though it's a close range weapon. You always expect the much more faster agile sniper rifle to have quite a significantly faster fire rate. This is not the case between these two weapons. The Kar98K should be shooting faster, it would make it a better gun. Maybe in a future buff, I'm not too sure, but anyways, the time in between each shot for the Kar98K was 94 frames. Since we're recording in 60 frames per second, we can hit that with the conversion. That means the times between each shot was 1.5 seconds. Hit that with another conversion to get seconds to minutes. That brings us down to 0.0261 minutes in between shots. That gives us a total of 38 rounds per minute. Don't forget your sig figs, kids. Doing the same math for the AX50 gives us 36 rounds per minute. Not much of a difference at all. The Kar98K is a bit faster, but you would definitely want the gap between those two numbers to be a bit bigger. That's pretty much all I wanted to test. I did do things like the reload speeds, which were pretty similar. Didn't seem too significant to include in this video. So I just wanted to finish up with a summary. We started with the mobility, the notion that the Kar98K is the quickscoper's weapon. So yeah, we determined it was faster, like putting the hybrid on a no-scoped assault rifle. That was the difference between the two weapons. I made the assumption that you would be using a scope on the Kar98K because the iron sights are really bad. And listen, if you're using the iron sights for the Kar98K, you're going to start using it like an MK2 carbine, which is not what you want, because the MK2 carbine is so much better at what it does than the Kar98K. So you want to make sure that you're using it like a sniper. So yes, the Kar98K was faster, but the AX50 seems to be slower than it actually is. That's when we talked about how it needed a few extra frames to completely center up with the target. However, the scope was zoomed in and on target for the most part fairly quickly, unlike the Kar98K, which just snapped right dead center to the target. The AX50 kind of took those few extra frames to really align itself centerally. However, up close where that difference is not noticeable, the AX50 is very fast, faster than maybe the eye can pick up without going into detail like we did. The AX50 can one-shot from the waist up. The Kar98K can never be in a situation where it's going to one-shot from the waist up. Its voice has to be from the upper chest and above. This is really big when you're kind of in a panic, you're up close and personal, and you don't have time to really aim and be that precise. And along with that, the AX50 has better range, so it was able to one-shot kill from the waist up at ranges where the Kar98K can't even one-shot from the chest up. So that's a pretty big difference, the fact that you've got all that mass to shoot at, whereas the Kar98K at these ranges can only shoot at the head to kill. Once again, maybe these ranges are too extreme to be talking about when we're dealing with quickscoping, but you can't deny that in-game you're going to find yourself in these long-range situations, and using the AX50 will allow you to be useful at these ranges. The Kar98 had much less flinch compared to the AX50. The AX50, when shot, you just flail up off target, and it's going to make it very hard to get those shots off if you're not the first one to shoot. The Kar98K didn't have that problem. It stayed on target, and it might even give you that old school Call of Duty flinch to the headshot insta-kill thing that's going on there. And along with that, we discovered that we only dressed up our Kar98 with four attachments, leaving it with one extra attachment up to your choice. You can use that on a weapon perk so you don't affect the mobility and the aim down sight speed of the weapon, such as focus, sleight of hands. Finally, both guns have the same fire rate. The Kar98 falls short here. You'd want it to have a much faster fire rate, considering it can't do nearly the damage that the AX50 does. And that's gotta be everything that we talked about today. So my work here is done, I think. I hope that I have showed you enough for you to make a decision on which gun you would prefer to use, which gun is more advantageous to the way you play this game, because I gotta be honest with you, before I went and delved into the details of this Kar98, I thought the gun was complete dog shit. I mean, I got it gold, grinded it out, and but now with the testing that I've done, I definitely see it has its ups, it has its uses, and that's for sure. So I'm pretty torn myself on which gun I think is more advantageous to use, or at least more torn than I would expect it to have been at the start of this video, considering my prior opinion of the Kar98. But let me know what you guys think. Let me know which weapons you would like to see compared the next time we make this goddamn gray hair, tedious inducing type of video. I am freaking gassed. I don't want to work on this video anymore, so I'm just gonna go. All right, see ya.